structure, all of our substations, so we had no power.
Don Zimmer was mayor of Hoboken, New Jersey, when Hurricane Sandy hit 6 years ago. She told us the city of 55,000 people right across the Hudson River from Manhattan was almost entirely underwater.
In some neighborhoods, 10 feet of water?
10 feet of water, yes. And there was fish in people's apartments, it was waste, it was oil, it was a toxic mix in our city.
She said Hoboken got money from FEMA to put things back pretty much the way they were, but she wanted to rebuild smarter.
It doesn't help for me to have a fire station is individually protected, but there's water all around it. That fire station won't be able to help anyone in the middle of a storm. It just doesn't make sense.
So why can't you just get the money and use it as you see best?
That's just not the way it works.
She says that's when Hank Ovink entered the picture. Sean Donovan, then Secretary of Housing and Urban Development, tapped Ovink for President Obama's Hurricane Sandy Task Force. The two came up with an idea for an international design competition to fix what Sandy had destroyed, following the Dutch philosophy, rebuild differently for the future. Ovink helped convince the federal government to cough up almost $1 billion for it.
You know, in the U.S., that sounds kind of crazy.
Yeah.
$1 billion for a competition to rebuild. Something like that had never been done before.
Never been done in this capacity, so they also had to believe my blue eyes and my story and saying, okay, we believe this young man coming from the Netherlands. Let's work with him.
A proposal that will protect Hoboken and its neighbors was awarded $230 million of the competition money. A Dutch design team came up with the winning plans, with a Dutch twist. A storm surge defense disguised as a park with a boathouse. Benches and outdoor seating as barriers to keep the Hudson from drowning the city again. Coming up with the plan was the easy part. Convincing residents to go along was much harder.
There were people that were calling out, like, give back the money.
So let me get this clear, that even after the devastation of Sandy, people were not convinced that they needed flood protection?
People were really concerned, for example, about their property values. What would the property values of Hoboken be if we're flooded on a regular basis and our entire city is destroyed?
After consulting with the community, the plans were amended, and most residents got on board. Hoboken plans to break ground next year. It could be the first test for Ovink's vision in the U.S.
It's going to move forward, and I'm very confident that when that next storm hits, because it's going to hit, it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when, and we will be prepared, and we will be a model to show that this approach can work.
It's a choice in the end. It's a human choice. We can think about that future as an opportunity, or close our eyes and do nothing and let it happen to us and see more death and despair, more assets and people lost.